Today we are going to do this exercise that you see on your screen. This is the fourth sketch exercise. We have already done three before this. So if you have not done those exercises, I'd suggest you to complete those first before you move on to this particular exercise, since this is relatively more complex. Now, if you haven't subscribed to the channel, I'd suggest you to please subscribe to the channel so that we can grow together. Now coming to the exercise itself. Now this sketch, if you see, it's actually sort of symmetrical about the vertical axis. So it would be my attempt to make this point as my origin, okay, so that I can make it easily symmetrical about vertical, and I'll try and coincide this particular axis coincide with the vertical of my sketch. Okay, I have already opened Catia and I am in Sketcher workbench. So let's start. I'll start off by making this circle that you see. Okay, it's of radius 18. So let's start by making this particular circle. I'll take this origin as the circle center and make the circle. Okay, let me apply the constraints to this is of radius 18. So okay, so I've made this small circle. There's a line coming downwards from here. Okay, so let me make this profile. Okay, then the line goes actually outwards, and upwards, and upwards, and upwards. Okay, something like this. Now I've coincided this with this particular line horizontal, okay, because here also it sort of coincides. Okay, so let me apply constraints here. I know this distance is actually 15. So let me apply this distance 15. This is 12. Be very careful when you are applying these distances. Okay, this distance is actually 12. Okay. And I know this is 4. Okay. Also, this distance is known to us. Okay, this is 45, if you see. Okay, there's a line actually going inwards from here, so let me make this line also. Okay, something like this. Okay. Now, there is a similar sort of profile here. Let me make that also. Okay, this is 15 as we can see from here. Okay, so let me apply some constraints here as well. What about this is 9? This may look like 6, but it's 9. Okay, and this distance is actually 12. This distance is also known to us. This is 45. Okay, now I can trim the circle if I want. Okay, so let me just trim this. Okay, now there is a similar circle outside. Okay, this smaller circle, which is actually concentric to this circle, so let us make that circle next. Okay, the circle. Okay, this has a radius that I can see is of 36. Okay. Okay. So I can actually trim the circle if I want. So let's trim this. Okay, so test profile is complete. Now we can move on to profile, that is upwards. Okay, this circle, this line. Okay, so we can make this line. So let me first make this line, because I know that this is actually 20. Okay, this line, I know this line is actually 20. Okay, so let me make this as 20. I also know that this is located at a distance of 158 from this particular line. So let me apply this distance to 158. Okay. Now I said that this sketch, this upper portion is actually symmetrical about vertical. So I can actually make these two points symmetrical about vertical. Okay. Okay, something like this. And I can make two vertical lines, okay, dropping from this particular horizontal. Okay. Now this circle is there that you see. Okay, before I make that circle, let me just make the smaller circle instead. This circle is coinciding with the center is actually coinciding with the vertical. Okay, so that's okay, but diameter is 14, so let me apply that diameter. Okay, what about its distance? I know that this is actually at a distance of 29 from above. Okay, so this is done. Okay, there is an outer arc, okay, which is actually having the same center as this particular circle, but it has a radius of 14. Okay, this particular arc, I can also make this particular arc also. So let's make this arc. Okay, this has a radius of 14. Okay, so this is done. Okay, now what else? Now let us make these lines. Okay, these lines are there. Okay, the circle is there. Let us make profiles which are actually well known, and their distances and constraints are well known. Let me make the circle first, and it has a dia of 14. So let me apply this diameter value. This is 14. Okay, I can make two more smaller circles. Okay, so something like this. This other circle is actually symmetrical about this circle, right? So what I can do is I can actually mirror this circle. Okay, rather than creating a circle and then applying symmetry, what I can do is I can directly mirror also. So this transformation I can apply about vertical. Okay, so I now have two circles. So let me apply dia 10. Okay, these are two holes of diameter 10, as you can see here. Distances between them is also known. This is 34, I know. Okay, and I also know that their location is 40 from this particular. Okay, so I can right click, it is giving me this particular distance, but I can right click to make it vertical. Okay, and this distance is known to me, it is 40. Okay, and distance between these two circles and this circle is actually known, it is 38. This and this is 38. Okay, Now I can make other profiles. Let me make this line, okay, the vertical line. There's another line symmetrical to this, so let me just use transformation and apply it about vertical, okay, something like this. There's a circle, or I can say I can use 3-point arc starting with limits. These are my limits. Okay, I can make an arc, something like this. Okay, this arc is having tangency with this as well. Okay, and I know that it has a radius of 8. And distance of this with respect to these two circles is known. Okay, this is 17. Okay, now I know that this circle has been made. Okay, this circle, this arc has been made. Now I can make this particular circle. Okay. Okay, this circle has a radius of 20. Okay. So let's make this circle. Okay, so what I can do is I can actually apply radius value. Okay, so let me apply radius with no trim between this and this circle. Okay, it has a radius of 5. This also has a radius of 5. So trim it. Okay, we trim this line as well. This circle. Okay. Also this circle. Okay. So I have now have a profile which is sort of looks okay. So, what about this particular circle? This particular circle is actually center is coinciding with this. Okay, so let me make them as coincident. Okay. Alright, so we have now profiles which resemble our sketch. Okay, so now what about this particular circle? Okay, let us make this bigger circle and let me press shift key, and it has a radius of 36. Okay, but what about its center? This actually center coincides with this circle. Okay, so coincidence. Okay, let us apply radiuses with, okay, we can apply it later on. Let us first apply create lines. Okay, this line, let's create some line. This line is actually tangent to this circle, so let me apply tangency. Okay, and it extends into this particular circle, right? Something like this. And there is a line symmetric to this, so let me select this line and apply transformation and make it symmetric. Okay, something like this. Now we can trim a little bit. Let us trim. What we can do is, actually I can trim this particular circle with respect to this line. Okay, and this. Okay, so we now have extra this line, these lines. Okay, so let us trim that as well. Okay, now this distance is actually known to us, this particular distance, this point and this point. Okay, this distance is known to us, which is 36. Okay, and looks like the sketch is complete almost. Let me just remove extra lines which are there. Okay, now looks complete. Let us investigate. I think I've applied all the constraints. Okay, looks like I forgot to apply certain radiuses, so let me apply those radiuses first. I'll use the trim option, trim all elements. Okay, and let me rather double click here. So this radius is actually 6, so let me make this 6. This radius is also 6. Okay, let's move downwards. Here I'll use the no trim, I'll use this option rather, construction lines trim. Okay, I'll apply radius between these two and this will be 6. I'm using construction lines trim because I've applied this particular constraint on these points, so I don't want this point to be lost. Okay, this is also 6. Okay, and there's a radius here, 8, radius here as well. Okay, so now this looks complete. Okay, now this looks complete. So let me just use this. It shows as ISO constraint. Okay, so I trust this. It shows as ISO constraint. That means there is no free point or line. Everything is fully constrained. Let me just close this. If you like the video, please give it a like. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. In the next video, we'll probably be starting part design workbench. So stick around. And thank you for watching.